With such a wide and wild introduction, you have nothing less to speak. I was carefully listening to the two speeches made before me. One, really high on AI, and the other, really high on grassroots. And I would try to make the balance between the two. I'm reminded of one somebody said in Urdu, so I would like to share it. Jis kaum ko mitne ka ehsaas nahi hota, us kaum ka duniya mein itihaas nahi hota. To bring back and linking it to digital is, I always believe that if you rightly use dil se Gita, it becomes digital. And those who want to check it, they can check it right now. The spelling of digital has dil and Gita together. It's not a purpose to give you digression because all of you are fairly intelligent. And in government, we can always claim to having AI. We are intelligent, but our intelligence is generally artificial. And even reality, view of reality is also slightly augmented. But if you have listened to Mr. Agarwal's speech, if you look at the priority at the government level, the priority at government level, when a welfare government comes and takes over office in a peaceful transition of power, as was enumerated by sir, it is for the welfare of the people. And I'm one of those who believe that you need a strategy to do it. Digital can be added. If you have no good product to offer, any amount of digital can't make you very relevant. If I am financing non-performing asset, even digitally financed NPA will continue to be NPAs. But yes, using artificial intelligence or new technologies or new age technology, if we put it mildly, we can certainly bring Nirav Modi's and Choksi's back to India. Because we can today monitor where they ate their breakfast and which bed they slept yesterday. And maybe today or tomorrow, hands of law will reach to their nearer to them. Those days are gone when people used to fly. I mean, we still remember East India days. Companies transferred millions and billions from poor India. Nobody could trace even a single pie out of it. Today's East India's oligarchs, if they move with money from India, belonging to the people of India, they can be traced, they can be tracked, and they can be perhaps be made to pay. And all this is due to digital technology. Autonomous vehicle, whether we need it, autonomous drivers, we need it, or AI-enabled doctors, we need it. That could be debated. But can we avoid it? Answer is clear, no. I'm one of those who believe that we live in a country where 2018 is, we live in a country where 2018 AD and BC is relevant today also. There are a group of people who are 40, 55, maybe 400 million people who live in 2018 BC. They are as ignorant of technology as people who are living in 2018 in 21st century or 22nd century aspirations, who want to buy the best, who can afford to buy the best, who cannot live without being with them. And people are committing suicide not to get their autonomous vehicle parked in India. They feel they are, some of them might be having sleepless night. Are mera to bhi Tesla 3 aaya nahi. Whereas some people are fighting for a space in the bus. Can they get a bus and reach their destination? Limited point is that government's job will continue to be roti kapda makan. Today we have added broadband also. Today country is aiming for what we call it 3 billion things. 1 billion Janathan account, 1 billion Aadhaar card, 1 billion mobile phones. So that delivery of government services which are possible digitally, at least they can be delivered. Who could imagine that 29 crores of account have been opened in Jandhan. Was it possible without digital, which has not been adopted by the banks? Everyone has to walk at least 3 miles to get his first 100 rupees from a bank. Today you need to, you can transfer the money by using Bheem application without going anywhere. And we are still living in the same country where nothing much has changed except digital. And digital landscape has changed so much that any reversal is simply impossible. Yes, security issues are there, privacy concerns are there, data selling is there, data thieves are there, in fact, data dacoits are emerging. Your data can be sold 10 times in a day, maybe 1,000 times in a day without you knowing. Even the consent, the way they ask, I don't think anyone of us ever read it. Even Tim Cook must not have read when he says, I accept the condition of when I download iOS 3 or iOS 11 or 11.3. Even his whole team who are involved in the security audit, they must not have read 1,200 pages, that too in 0.6 font. When you say, I agree. And what do you say? You take out all my photos, you take my entire itinerary, you take what I ate, you take what whom did I talk, you can also take all that I am proposed to do throughout the day, throughout this month's engagement. And all thing is happening seamlessly. Somebody was saying you walk with a particular phone. The company knows where you are sitting, where you are going, where you are eating, what you are talking, and why you are talking. So the disruption in terms of technology has happened in such a manner that now it has become even happiness is at stake. I was always believing that privacy is at stake. Privacy can be secured through laws, but happiness cannot be secured through laws. Because I become restless the moment I get a blinker in my mobile phone, as if Donald Trump is waiting to talk to me. I become restless if I don't open an email, as if Korean War is going to be settled today. And we all become restless if a common message comes in WhatsApp, unless you read it. But there are people who are managing their happiness. Sir, I would like to share one example and I will close there. Recently, there was a get-together of IAS officers. CAPSEC was also there. We announced an award. Who has the maximum unread WhatsApp messages, he will be given an award. And one Secretary of Defense Protection won the award also, sir. We all know him. And can you imagine how many unread messages he has? Make a wild guess. Any one of you, I can't give you a reward like Mr. Sahu because he has got a lot of rewards and all those things. Can we imagine how many unread messages an IAS officer had in his mobile? Make a wild guess, anyone? How much? 800, anyone more? 10,000, anyone more? No, it is too much. He has 15,482 messages. Unread, and he was rewarded. I mean, salute to patience of such person who are carrying so much of knowledge and wisdom, which is shared through WhatsApp early morning, namaskar, to so many messages of from death to birth, from being passionate spiritually to as if world is going to fall today. And I do believe that if you stay away from your feet, from your phone, even 3 feet away, you have at least some degree of anxiety added to your blood pressure. Is it what technology we have invented for? I don't know whether this is the point to pontificate on these lines, but fact remains that somebody should question why of technology. What is known to you and how it works is known to you much more. But is there any limit why what technology can disrupt your peace and tranquility? It's a big convenience one can understand, but convenience at a cost which all of us are paying. Somebody was saying it is free of cost. Anything which is free of cost, then you are the product, gentlemen. Who will give you free of cost? Today, look, avkaat dekar namaste karte hain. If you are in power at the right seat, they will say hello to you. If you are shifted by one notification, they will not say hello to you also. Even the same company, passwords are deactivated. By the time you get to pink, red and white slip, password is deactivated first and faster. Same artificial intelligence works against you. Government winds blow against us. I'm one of those believe that digital has a lot of possibility, but digital also have to have the responsibility inbuilt in. But today, in environment of artificial intelligence, AI, OT, M2M learning, deep learning, and all those kind things, we have no choice but to learn these things and maybe learn as fast as possible. Sir was telling that we missed Industrial Revolution 1 because we were colonized at that time. We missed Revolution number 2, Industrial Revolution 2. We had no resources. But IO4 or 4.0 Industrial Revolution, we need not miss because we have the capability. Today, service sector India is leading. We have become workhorse of the world. Artificial intelligence, digital technologies can make us also producers of goods and services for the world. Those days are not far off. Software will write software, sir, it is true. But Indians will write the software of the world, and those days are not far off. Reason is not that we are aspirational. Reason is that we are not only committed to solve the problem of the world, we are looking back to solve the problem of India also. People are coming back from abroad to look into our own problem. Once upon a time, brain drain was a good idea because at least brain was not in the drain. Today, brains are coming back to solve the problems of India. We should encourage them, we should support them, and the time has come to celebrate their successes. Today, we are going to celebrate some successes. I have come here only to learn. I thought I will also unlearn something in the initial process, and this is my process of unlearning myself, because AI, all these things one has to learn. You have to come clean some data from your memory. And I thought this much memory I will control or delete so that I can learn the rest part of the lesson today. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, for giving me a chance. Thank you.